Dominus vobis cum.
Et cum spiritus tuo.
Oremus. Domine sancti Pater omnipotens et omnipotens, qui omni ex nihilo creati, et justitia propria apum, ut decorum et perfectionis ceteri beneficiisti, et qui hodien et die petitionem justi simone simpler esti, te humilita deprecamo, ut hanc canalis ad lisi hominem, et sanitatem culpum et animum sibi in terra, sibi in aquas purificationis tui sanctissimi nominis, et per intercessione beata mea semper virginis, cuius hodie festa devota celebrantur, et per preces omnium sanctorum tuum, benedicere, et sanctificare digneris, ut huius plebis tui quae illus honificie, et manibus desirat portare, tecum candare laudare, exadius fortius de cele sancta tui, et de sede maestatis tui, et propitius et omnibus clamanibus et se, quod pos redemis di precios sanguine filia tui, qui te convivitat regna, in unitat Dei Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Oremus, omnipotens, semper Deus, qui hodie die unigenitum tuum, onus sanctus simonus in tempo sancto tui, suscibiendum Christum pasti, turum supplus deprecamur clementium, ut hanc candelas, vas familius tui in tui nominis veni vicentium, suscibiendis gestare pulchris, luce sensas, benedicere, et sanctificare, acque lumine superi benedictionis, ascendere digneris quittinis, eius tibi domine Dei nostri offerendi digni, et sancti institutissime caritatis tui sensi, in templo sancti gloria tui representari mirantum, unum dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui te convivitat regna, in unitat Dei Spiritus Sancti Deo, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Oremus, Domine Iesu lux veri quae illumina, omnium hominem veniente minus mundum, et funde benedictionem tuum, super hostiteris, et sanctifica eos lumine gratia tui, et concede propitius ut sic hanc luminarii, igne visibile accensa nocturnus, depilen tenebras ita quodus nostri invisibili, igne ides, sanctus spiritus benduilus lastra, omnium vitiorum cacitatum cariat, ut pegatum mentus oculor, eas eneri possimus, quae tibi sunt placida et nostris litur utilia, quid in esposuius seculi cacrus et decrimina, ad lucem nidifentem pepineri miriam mo, per te Christi Iesu sabata mundi, qui in trinitate perfecta vivis et regnus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Oremus, omnipotens sempiterna Deus, qui per mersum familum, durum brusum ole liquorum, ad luminari anticonspectum tuum, judica concinanda preparari justisti, benedictionis, dura gratiam super hostitus benius infunde, quitena sic administrant lumen exitus, orte donata lumen spiritus tui nostri, non desert menibus interiors, per dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, quite convivitat regna, in unitat Deus spiritus sancti Deo, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Oremus, Domine Iesu qui hodien et die in nostris canons substantienta homilies apparens, apparentibus in tempore eis presentatus, quem si manus venibus senex lumine spiritus tui fundatus, ad nervisuship et benedixit, Christa propsis ut iustum spiritus sancti gratia illuminati, acquia doci de veracita agnos camus, et fidelity legamus, We come there, Patri Unitate, Eastern Spirit Sancti, Vivus et Regnus Deus, Per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Salutare tuum. Thank you.
protegamus in pace.
In nomine Christi, amen.
Yeah. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
Substantium templum, es presentatus et nos facies purificatus, tibi mentibus presentari, unum dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui te convivit regna, et in sacro spiritus sancti Deo, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Dominus Deo, et ego mit angelum me, et peperavit via manti facium mea, et statum venida temptum suum dominator, quem vos creatus et angelus testamenti, quem vos voltum, et je benedicit dominus exitum, et quis postera cogitare diem et benus eo, equis tabet ad videndum eo, ipse enum quasi ignus complans, et quasi hebe fulonum, et sedebe complans, et mundus argumento, et begabit bilis labia collocabit eis quasi arum, et quasi agendum et erum domini operandis, sacrificia in justitia. Et placebit dominum sacrificium iuda, et Jerusalem sicut dia saeculi, et sicut annia antiqui, dicit dominus omnipotens.
Dominus vobis tu. Sequentia sancti evangelii secundum Lucam.
Gloria tibi,
in illo tempore, post comin pleni sunt dies pagationis Mariæ, secundum legimosi tulerunt Iesum in Jerusalem, assistere Deum Domine, sicus cutum es in lege Domini, qui omne masculinum apparens volvum sanctum Domino vocabitur, et ut darit hostium secundum, quod dicam es in lege Domini, paustuturum aut duos pullos columbarum, et ecce homo erant in Jerusalem, cuiat nomen Simonum, et homo iste justus itemeratus, expectans consolationem Israel, et Spiritus Sanctus erat in eo, et respondem ex shepherd Spiritus Sancto, non visum se mortem, nisi prius viderent Christum Domini, et venet in spiritu in templum, et cum induet cerunt purem Iesum parentes eos, ut facerunt secundum consuetudinem, legis per ea, et ipse ex shepherd enim in urnas suas, et benedixum Deum et dixit, nunc dimittis servantum Domine, secundum verbum tuum in pace, quia viderent oculi mei salutari tuum, quod parasti ante faciem omnium populum, lumen ad revelatium gentium, et gloriam plebis tuus Israel.
Please blow your candles out now, and the candles are then lit again at the Sanctus. So we have them lit for the canon now, so they should be blown out now. After Mass, if you can keep the candle, but if you can return the cups, the servers will collect the cups at the exit, so we can use them again. But please feel free to take your candle home with you, the blessed candle. And those who have had candles blessed, come to the altar rail and the service will give you your candles afterwards. So please return the cups afterwards and you can take the candle home with you here on Candlemas. Tomorrow we have St. Blaise Feast Day, and so the blessing for throats will take place after Mass, after the hymn. St. Blaise is the patron saint of sore throats, so please get the blessing after Mass. Now we hear in the Gospel, after the days of Mary's purification, according to the law of Moses, were accomplished, they carried Jesus to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord. Today's feast day has many great names: the purification of Our Lady, the presentation of the baby Jesus in the temple, the fourth joyful mystery, and of course it's known by Candlemas Day. But why is it called Candlemas Day? Well, it's called Candlemas Day because of the solemn blessing of candles, which of course are carried in procession this day, and the day when all candles were blessed for the year ahead. Now, this blessing of candles dates back to the time of St. Gelasius, who governed the church towards the close of the 5th century. During the time, paganism prevailed in Rome, and several feasts were celebrated in the month of February in honour of the pagan gods, at which the most horrible debaucheries were indulged in. Thus, on the fifth day of the month, the so-called Lupercalia, in honour of the god Pan, took place. During this time, they indulged in evil things and carried torches in solemn marches at which the Romans celebrated their victories over all the nation. Now, when Christianity, of course, obtained a footing in Rome, the church endeavoured to suppress these pagan feasts or change them into Christian months. Saint Gelasius introduced the feast of Candlemas and ordained on this day a solemn procession should take place with candles that are blessed. So that's what we've been in profession of our holy faith, asking the blessings of God upon St. Anne's and each one of us. We carried our candles in procession around the church in imitation of those early Christians of Rome. So what do the candles symbolise then? The candles carried symbolise our Lord Jesus Christ, the incarnate Word of God, the incarnate Son of God, and the light of the world. Now the wax that candles are made of should be pure. Traditionally, candles were made of beeswax. The bees which prepare the wax are exceptionally clean insects. They tolerate nothing unclean either in themselves or in their hives. Thus, the pure wax from which the candles are made represent to us the pure humanity of our Lord. The clean bees which prepare the wax symbolize Mary, the Mother of God, in whose pure womb the humanity of Christ has been prepared by the Holy Ghost. Now, the bright light that we have ascending from the candle signifies the divinity of Christ. Light is frequently used in Holy Scripture as an emblem of the Godhead. God is light, and in him there is no darkness. So wrote St. John in his first epistle. Our Lord himself, of course, calls himself the bearer of light, teacher, revealer, and sanctifier. Thus our Lord said in St. John's Gospel, I am the light of the world. He that followeth me walketh not in darkness, but shall have the light of life. I am come a light into the world, that whoever believes in me may not remain in darkness. And we all need that light of Christ, that we may remain in the light. The lighted candles remind us particularly of the words of Holy Simeon in the Gospel today. Because my eyes have seen thy salvation, which thou hast prepared before the face of all peoples, a light to the revelation of the Gentiles and the glory of thy people Israel. St. Luke chapter 2. Our Lord is the light who dispels the darkness of the world, and the light which he has brought to men is the knowledge and worship of Almighty God. For through the church he announces his doctrine to all men and to the end of time, and shows them the way to eternal salvation, and administers the necessary grace for it through the sacraments. The lighted candles teach us that as Catholics we must never lose sight of the words of the Apostle. Mind the things that are above, not the things that are upon the earth. So says St. Paul to the Colossians chapter 3. And as we know, we can turn a candle anyway. Please hold them straight though tonight. And the light always points up. The light of the candle always points up. And from this we learn that our thoughts and desires should be directed to heavenly, not earthly things. As St. Paul said to the Hebrews, we have here not a lasting city, but we seek that one which is to come. Hebrews chapter 13. So while passing through the temple, we should not forget that which is eternal. And the candles teach us that we should seriously consider our days have become less and less on earth until finally life itself is altogether extinct. If we light a candle, we see it burn down, and eventually it burns itself out. If there's no more wax, it has consumed itself. And so it is with all our lives. We are reminded of the shortness and brevity of life. The candle tells us, watch, for death is already on its way. As I consume myself, and I do not know how long I shall burn. Show your life grows less every day, and you will not know what. You do not know when it will be extinguished. And also the candles teach us that we should shine before all men with a good example. Let your light shine before all men, said our Lord. And as the lighted wax candles spread their light around, so we as children of the light must in all things show ourselves the example of good works. Actions, of course, speak louder than words. And as we know, nothing exercises a greater influence than good example. It corrects the sinner, strengthens the weak, and perseveres the good on the way of virtue. Even the procession tonight, carrying the candles, lights up the world and gives all here present and those around us a good example to follow. As we know, anyone can speak about doing good or can easily criticise and judge other people. But it's much harder to follow things with deeds and to lead by a good example. This will, of course, please God and please all good people. So on Candlemas today, we should do what the candles teach us, to frequently raise our eyes to heaven and consider that all earthly goods and joys which the children of the world in all their blind and perverse sense esteem so highly are vain and fleeting. We are not made for this world, but the next. And anything in this world will profit nothing at the hour of death. As our Lord said, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his justice, and all other things will be given unto you. And consider that this life is only a short span of years, and always be careful about having a happy death. And be not content with living piously oneself, but endeavour by good example to edify one's fellow man and encourage them to great virtue. And observe all the lessons that the lighted candle teach you, that you may be children of the light and may be admitted after this life into the heavenly Jerusalem, where perpetual life will shine upon you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Ghost.
Thank you. Thank you.
saecula saeculorum.
Oremus,
bishop de salutaribus monarchi, et divina institutione formati, ad eimus dicere, pater noster qui es in celis, sanctificetur nomen tuum, adveniat regnum tuum, fia voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et dimitte nobis debita nostra, sicut et nos dimittimus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentationem.
Sed libera nos a malo.
Oh. Gloria Grazie.